Hello and welcome back to a new video in the Classical Cipher series on the Crypto2 YouTube channel. In this video, I want to show you how you can build your own simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher using Crypto2. I want to also show you how you can break monoalphabetic substitution ciphers. I also created a small overview what we want to do in this video. But first of all, what is a simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher? I created a small definition what a monoalphabetic substitution cipher is. In cryptography, a simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher replaces the letters of the plaintext with the letters from a single ciphertext alphabet. Each individual plaintext letter is always replaced with exact the same ciphertext letter. The cryptographic key of the simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher is a mapping from plaintext alphabet to ciphertext alphabet. And here, some questions arise. First of all, question 1, what is a plaintext or a ciphertext alphabet? And we have two answers. First, for the plaintext alphabet. In our case, a plaintext alphabet is the Latin alphabet. That means the letters A, B, C, D, and so on, X, Y, Z. So the complete Latin alphabet is our plaintext alphabet, as you can see here. The second answer is the ciphertext alphabet is a permutation of the plaintext alphabet. For example, you have X, Z, T, Y, and so on, P, Q, R. And this means the letter A is encrypted with X, the letter B is encrypted with Z, the letter C is encrypted with T, and so on and so on and so on, and the letter Z is encrypted with the letter R. Then we have a second question, how many different keys and a key is a ciphertext alphabet exist. And this, of course, can easily be answered by, with the Latin alphabet used as plaintext alphabet, there exists the 26 factorial ciphertext alphabets. And this is approximately about 2 to the power of 88 keys. This also means that we cannot use simple brute force search like in the previous videos to break the simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher. That leads us to our next question. How can we actually break a simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher while it has such a huge key space? And the answer is we can use language statistics to break the simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher, and that easily and also by hand. But of course, in this video, we will use Crypto2 to break the cipher. And Crypto2 uses different heuristics, which also uses language statistics in the background. And this brings us to the two tasks that I want to perform in this video. Task 1 is, of course, to create a simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher in Crypto2. And then A, encrypt some text, and of course B, decrypt the text. And the second task is to actually break ciphertext, which has been encrypted with the monoalphabetic substitution cipher. I'm here now in the start center of Crypto2. I want to show you different ways of creating a simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher. First, we start the Workspace Manager by clicking on this icon here. In the Workspace Manager, I make some more space for our graphical program by closing the log messages. Then, in the search of the components bar, I search for substitution. Then I drag and drop the substitution cipher component on the workspace. As you can see, the component has 3 inputs and 1 output. The first input is the text input, which takes plaintext or ciphertext. And we have a text output, which outputs plaintext or ciphertext. Then we have the source alphabet, which is our plaintext alphabet. And we have our destination alphabet, which is our ciphertext alphabet. First of all, I drag and drop from the text input onto the workspace, and I select text input. Then I take the text input component and make it a little bigger. And I rename this component to plaintext. Now we need an additional text input for the plaintext alphabet. And we connect the plaintext alphabet with the source alphabet. And I do the same for the ciphertext alphabet. and I connect the ciphertext alphabet with the destination alphabet. And finally, I create a text output by dragging and dropping from the output connector and create a text output. And this is our ciphertext. Now we need some text that we want to encrypt. So let's encrypt "Hello World." This is a test of the monoalphabetic substitution component. Now we need a plain text alphabet. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And we need to copy this to the ciphertext alphabet. And now we have to make a permutation of this. You can do this, for instance, by just selecting something from here, copying it to there, the same here. And now we have a permutated ciphertext alphabet. So let's see if the component works. But first of all, we check if the substitution is set to encrypt. How should unknown symbols be handled? That means, for instance, a space or a comma. And we set this to leave as is. And the rest is not so important right now. So let's press play and see our result. And as you can see here, the plain text is forwarded to the substitution component. Then inside the substitution component, it is encrypted according to our plain text alphabet and our ciphertext alphabet, and we see the ciphertext. And we can make a short test if it works right. Let's see, we have here the letter H, and the letter H should be encrypted too. We just double click on the substitution and open the presentation, and the letter H should be substituted by the letter F. We can close this here. And you see here H and F. Let's test it again for E. So the letter E is U in the ciphertext. So let's double click on the substitution component, and the E is substituted by the letter U. Now let's stop the workspace and let's create another substitution component to decrypt the text. So I just press Ctrl C and Ctrl V. And I connect the output of the ciphertext with the input of the substitution. Then we have, of course, to connect the plain text alphabet, and we have to connect the ciphertext alphabet. And I copy the ciphertext and rename it decrypt plain text and connect the substitution component with the new text output. And we change the substitution component to decrypt. And let's start it again. And as you can see, the plain text is first substituted and we have our ciphertext. And after that, it is again substituted, but in the reverse direction. So it's decrypted. And we see, "Hello world, this is a test of the monoalphabetic substitution component." And this is the first way of creating a simple monoalphabetic substitution. But of course, creating these ciphertext alphabets is difficult, and you have to copy and paste and so on. In Crypto 2, there's an easier way to create a ciphertext alphabet. In our components, we search for alphabet, and we have the alphabet permutator, which I drag and drop onto the workspace. And I delete my ciphertext alphabet. Then I connect the plaintext alphabet with the alphabet permutator. And then I connect the alphabet permutator with the substitution components. Now, what does the alphabet permutator do? The alphabet permutator is a component that permutates alphabets. And it has two other inputs. The first input I will connect to the text input. And this here is a key. Which can be connected to the alphabet permutator. And then we need a number input. And this is the offset for the key. Let's set it to 15. And our key is secret key. And now in the alphabet permutator, we have to set the order. We set it to descending. So what did I do? The alphabet permutator gets as input our plaintext alphabet. Then it changes the ordering in the descending order. And it uses the number input to put our secret key in the middle of the alphabet. And it removes the occurrences of all the letters that are used in the secret key. I connect a text output to the alphabet permutator, which I then name ciphertext alphabet. And I will execute our workspace again. And what you can see here now is that the ciphertext alphabet is in fact the reversed alphabet with our secret key at the 15th position. And the alphabet permutator of course takes care that no letter is used twice in the alphabet. And now we have a different substitution alphabet for our substitution, but we don't have to memorize the alphabet itself. All we have to memorize is the secret key that we use descending as order, and of course the offset of the key. Now let's actually break a simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher. But before I can show you how to break a simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher, I need to generate a ciphertext. I just copied a text from the Wikipedia, which is the description of substitution ciphers, and I paste it into our plain text. And then I change all the letters to uppercase. I do so by searching for the string operation component. Then I connect the first input of this component and the output of this component to the substitution cipher. And I say I want to have uppercase. And then I execute the workspace again. And now we have a substituted ciphertext. I copy this ciphertext for the analysis. As you can see, it can also be decrypted in our workspace. To actually break the ciphertext, I search for a template that allows the cryptanalysis of the simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher. So I search for substitution and I use the monoalphabetic substitution analyzer. In the analysis template, I just paste our ciphertext. Then I add an additional text input for our plaintext alphabet. And at the end, I add the space symbol. Then I have a look here. It's hill climbing, English, use spaces. And I just press play. And as you can see, it instantly solved our simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher. It tested about 33,000 keys, about 281,000 keys a second, and it took about a second to solve it. As you see here, in cryptography, a substitution cipher is a method of encrypting by which units of plaintext and so on. And this is everything I wanted to show you in this short video. Thank you very much for watching.